morning and welcome to your Life A to Z. I'm your host, Lisa Hafner, and I'm here with Dr. Theresa Ramsey from the Center for Natural Healing. I kind of asked you to do this because we hear so much about olive oils, right? Mm-hmm. And so many people cook with them, eat with them, but I'm like, are there good ones? Are there bad ones? And what do they really do for us?
Right, and we have to learn how to read the labels because the labels aren't always accurate. So we have to then look at the orchard. So
wow.
It's a pretty intense craft. You know, it's like wine. Olive oil.
So do your homework.
The quality of the oil is as good as the quality of the olive.
Well, we're going to dig more into that in just a little bit because now you've got me. Now I'm thinking, I don't see my bottle up. I'm a little worried.
There is so many. It's for a few.
Now back to Dr. Theresa Ramsey from the Center for Natural Healing talking about olive oil. So you say, I don't think I've ever grabbed a bottle and read the ingredients.
Right. You look for extra virgin olive oil, EVO, which is what most people look
for. Why extra virgin olive oil? I actually buy regular olive oil. Why is extra?
Okay. So you don't look for extra virgin. We should all look for extra virgin.
Okay. Well, there's two things I've done wrong. Don't read the ingredients. Why extra?
Because what the difference between extra virgin and virgin olive oil is the acidity.
Okay.
And extra virgin has to pass tests of being less than 1% acidic. And if it's not, then it can't be called that. And the really good olive oils are tested by an outside source, not by the company that made it, to make sure that it's chemical free. Oh. And that it was made properly.
Well, speaking of making them, you have a picture here, and this is just olives that I guess are getting ready to be pressed.
They're being ready to be pressed, and there they are, just mixed, and they're all different colors from the same tree, different areas of ripeness. And so those go into a container where it's just pressed until the oil just comes out. So it's not a mechanical machine, it's a hand machine that's done. And then we can see there's three different things. There's something that you want to look for in your olive oil, and it's the standards. And one is that it's made by hand.
Oh.
And the other is that it's not heated above 86 degrees.
So it's heated, but not above
that. Right, because if it's above that, you're not preserving the oil and the antioxidants and the phenols that are in there. So you want to make sure that it's not heated excessively.
I always thought that the extra virgin olive oil, well, chefs could probably answer that, would be used for like dips. But when it comes to like cooking fish, I use just the regular olive oil. But you want to use the extra for that as well.
You want to use that as well. And you can heat it as high as the smoking temperature. If you go beyond that, then you're breaking down your oil.
Right.
So let's say you're making a stir fry. You might want to do it in water, add the oil at the end so it's just coating your vegetables and your meats and so that you get the flavor, but you're not ruining the oil when you cook with it.
That's a good point, because I guess if you see a lot of smoke coming off that olive oil,
you're
destroying the properties of it.
Right.
That's interesting. So let's break down the different ones that you have here.
Right. So I brought a few. I mean, I could have brought a whole bunch more.
Okay.
If you have the privilege, like we do in Arizona, to have a specialty shop like Outrageous Olive Oils, maybe you've heard of them.
Mm-hmm.
They're one of the, you know, specialty shops that just has olive oil and vinegars. That's all they have. And what they have is the bins that are the premium oils. And when you go to get it filled, they fill your bottle there, because the moment it comes out of the bin, it starts to become broken down, or it starts to become rancid because it's exposed to air, light, and heat.
Oh.
So if you go there, they can fill it up fresh from the barrels that have three layers of protection.
Yeah, because it has a crush date on
it. And it has the crush date. Not many do. If you see a crush date, you can go 15 months out from that, and that's how long you want to use
it. Good. Yeah, that's a good point, too. When you buy olive oil, you know, you should store it, I think, in a dark place,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, you don't want a glass that is clear. You want it to have some color so that it protects it from the light.
Uh-huh.
You don't want it you don't want it warm. You don't want it in the refrigerator either. So you want it in a neutral environment. And you can tell by smelling it. I mean, that's what they do, a smell test, too, for the quality of each oil.
Hmm. So if it's in your cupboard, so about a year,
would olive oil last you a year? I go through a bottle a week.
Yeah, you're right. You know, I do go through it so much.
Mm-hmm.
But it's funny because the more expensive ones I save for just like dipping bread, not necessarily for cooking with.
Oh.
Now I'm going to have to cook with it too.
I recommend it because you're getting something that's been tested by a party outside of the company.
Yeah.
And a lot of bottles say olive oil, but some of them don't have any olives in them at all. They're
labeled.
Right. And people.
I don't think any of these are
none of these.
But if you look at the back, it should say pure olive oil, right?
In fact, this California olive oil, it's too small to show on TV, but it's got the California stamp of approval that says it meets all the standards for a healthy olive oil, extra virgin olive oil.
Especially since so many of us are consuming so much. Like you said, you go through quite a bit. You want it to be good olive oil.
Right, because it's so high nutrients. In fact, it is used for medicinal uses. Like, it is known to improve heart health.
Okay.
By lowering the
We'll talk more about that when we come back. We'll talk about all the benefits
perfect.
Of taking in all of this olive oil, if you're buying the right kind, which I apparently am not. So I learn something new every day on the show. Thanks, Dr. Ramsey.
Welcome.
So if you would like more information about the Center for Natural Healing, you can go to our website or dial our hotline. We're back with Dr. Theresa Ramsey from the Center for Natural Healing talking about olive oil again. A lot of people have had questions since we last saw you just a few minutes ago.
Yeah.
So let's first start with what the benefits are to
right.
having olive oil.
Well, Hippocrates, the father of medicine, called olive oil the great therapeutic because it really helped decrease incidence of heart disease, decrease the risk of diabetes, improved good cholesterol, decreased bad cholesterol. So there's a myriad of things it does because of a specific property in olive oil called phenolics. It's P-H-E-N-O-L-I-C, or phenolic compound. What they are is the antioxidants and anti-inflammatory properties.
Oh.
So your food that you're making is going to be as healthy as the oil that you're using.
And will it say that on these labels that it's in there?
You can go to their websites or, you know, go to the distributor, but not all of them do. Like some of them, you go to their site and they don't have any details, which means they're not making a really good olive oil.
Because we've talked about that earlier and a lot of people have asked, well, what does she mean? So you want it cold pressed,
yeah,
and you don't
pressed.
Want it heated up to a certain point, 86
degrees. Right, you don't
degrees.
Want to heat it. When we have it, we don't want to cook it above the smoking point, but when it's made and processed, not above 86 degrees. And there are some olive oil companies that I didn't bring that use solvents and heat to make faster oil to have a greater profit. They'll blend it with other oils. So if you're not careful, you can be taking in a toxin.
Yeah, and does it matter where they come from? Like what country? Like I would think Italian olive oil would be the
right.
best. But
I'm the same. Like I'd always go to, you know, the Italian or Mediterranean sources. That's where they originated. They came over to California and became popular in 2000, but we're here in 1700. Took a few years. And now there's California, I'm going to say vineyards, but orchards that are really good olive oil compared to the Mediterranean ones. They taste a little bit different. Mm-hmm. Like there's a bigger bite in the one that comes from.
Yeah, I was noticing the smell in a lot of these. You can really smell.
It's a lot stronger.
It's the extra virgin olive oil.
Right.
And Chef Gio, I asked him about, we talked about the heating. When you heat the olive oil, you lose it. He also said when you blend it.
Because you're heating it through a blender and breaking up the
particles.
It could
get bitter.
Right.
So be careful when you're using it as salad dressing.
Put it into a little Tupperware and shake
it. It's so good.
Instead of putting it into a blender. Like when you're mixing your vinegars with it and spices.
And what I learned through this whole thing is, you can taste the olive
oh, you can taste.
In olive oil. So
right.
if you can't
you
taste it in yours, it's probably not.
And smell it, too, because you'll smell the rancidity if it's an older oil in your cupboard, so you're not using it all the time.
That's
you can
true.
Smell the rancidity. It's easy to pick up on.
So all of these here that we talked about, you've kind of done the research, and they've already been proved. If they came from Italy, they've been checked, and then they get checked again.
In California, right, for outrageous olive oils. And olives are harvested once a year. And the pressing process is really extensive. So to make a really good olive oil is quite expensive.
Mm-hmm.
So expect to spend about $20 on a bottle.
Yeah, that was what I found out as well today. I knew there was a reason mine was so inexpensive because it may not be 100% pure olive oil. So do your research because a lot of us do cook with it.
Mm-hmm.
So you want to make sure you're getting the best that you can get for your body because you're using it probably more than you realize.
Right,
yeah.
right.
Thanks, Dr.
You're
Ramsey.
You're very welcome.
Good tips there about olive oil. Who knew? Now, for more information,